Hello everybody and welcome back to my true crime channel. I hope you're all well. So it would seem that DonWells was bonded out of jail, and what I'd like to know is who got Don out of prison. So I imagine most of you have heard by now that DonWells was arrested in the early hours of the morning on Halloween. He went out to buy cigarettes. He'd been on a live on No Thanks Investigates channel on YouTube, ran out of cigarettes. He'd been drinking whiskey. He actually showed the bottle of the whiskey on the live, so it was quite clear that he'd been drinking. He goes out to buy cigarettes, and then he's busted by the police for being drunk whilst driving. I'm not sure why, guys, but I was shocked by this. I know I've said it many times before, I shouldn't be shocked by Don Wells' behaviour, but I was shocked that 1 minute he's on YouTube, then he's going out to buy cigarettes, and then suddenly he's been busted by the police for drinking and driving. He could have killed someone. It really was such a stupid thing to do. Surely cigarettes aren't that important that it's worth putting other people's lives on the line. And not only did he put other people's lives on the line, he put his own life on the line. It's not going to help find Summer, and it's really rather ridiculous. So Don's bond apparently was $5,750, and that if someone did bail him out, they would have only paid 10% of that cost or of that figure. And also, apparently, whoever bailed him out will have had to have done it in person. So I'm really interested to know who bailed him out. Was it Candace? Was it a family member? There are rumours circulating that one of Don's cousins bailed him out. Could that have been Ronnie Lawson? Who knows? Really interesting. At first I thought it might have been one of Don's friends from YouTube, but obviously not all of them live near him in Tennessee. So did Candace have the money spared to bail him out? Did Grandma bail him out? I'm going to be really interested to know who paid the money to get Don out of prison. Surely whoever paid the bond shouldn't have paid it. They should have done Don a bigger favour than bailing him out of prison or jail. They should have left him there where maybe he could have cleaned up his act, got off the booze, and sorted his bloody life out. So, like I said, Don was pulled just after midnight on Halloween. He was done for driving under the influence, having an open container, which I presume was the whiskey we saw on the YouTube video. He also had an expired registration, improper lane usage, which I think is what he was pulled for because he was driving erratically, and also violation of financial responsibility, which a lot of people are saying is because he'd not paid his insurance on his car. So he wasn't just driving drunk, he was on the phone whilst driving drunk. Not only that, he didn't have any valid insurance. I mean, what on earth is going on here? Is this a man that wants to get his daughter back? Or is this a man that wants to be famous and wants to make money out of his daughter's disappearance? And is this a man that is using his brain? I don't think he's using his brain. I think he'd be better off staying off of YouTube, cleaning up his act, and then maybe him and Candace will get their sons back. Although, looking at their recent behaviour, I highly doubt that's going to happen anytime soon. This really is embarrassing for Don and Candace. I mean, God, they really have been behaving strangely lately. Candace is suddenly appearing on live videos on YouTube. Numerous videos she's appeared in. 1 minute she's happy and laughing, then she's crying, then she's hysterical. There have been quite a few live videos where Candace has been in the background, and you can hear and see that she's throwing things at Don's head while he's on these live videos. In another live video recently, she started playing very loud music in the background, and not only that, shouting at Don numerous times. Their relationship clearly is breaking down. It does often happen to parents of children that go missing, so it's hardly surprising. But maybe their marriage wouldn't be breaking down if Don didn't keep chatting up women on the internet, having weird women that he's met on Facebook constantly calling him. And not only that, Don constantly appearing in all of the YouTube videos that he does probably does put a strain on their marriage. I mean, if my other half was constantly on YouTube, had women that he'd met on Facebook ringing him, he wouldn't be my other half for much longer. So guys, who do you think got Don out of jail? Who do you think paid the bond? Have you heard that it was a cousin? Do you think it could be Sheriff Lawson? Because apparently Don and him are distant cousins. Who knows? I'm sure Don Wells does have more than one cousin, but I wouldn't be surprised if something dodgy has gone on here, if the police have somehow got him out. Or is it just that Candace had the money to get him out? Could it have been Grandma? Has she paid? I'm going to be extremely interested to know who got Don out of jail and in my opinion, they should have saved their money and left him there. Well, anyway, guys, pop your comments below. Let me know what you think. Who do you think paid Don's bond? Why do you think they did it? Do you think, like me, they shouldn't have bothered and they should have left Don in jail where maybe he could have sobered up and sorted his life out? So as always, guys, I will look forward to reading your comments on this. I have been very surprised by this, but I then question myself and think, why am I surprised? Why am I shocked that Don's been busted for drinking and driving? Sooner or later, the shit was going to hit the fan. Sooner or later, the pair of them are going to tip over the edge. And sadly, I wonder what's coming next. And I just hope it's not something more tragic than Don being busted for drinking and driving. Well, anyway, guys, I hope you're all well. I hope you had a fantastic weekend. And as usual, I'm going to be back with you all very soon for another true crime video. Bye for now. We'll be right back.